So that's your minimum intervening scheduling policy that is ensuring that the processor that is picked for TI to run on has the highest affinity for TI. That's the minimum intervening. And there's a variant of minimum intervening, which is called limited minimum intervening, which is essentially saying that if I have, let's say, 1,000 processes in the multiprocessor, then the amount of information that I want to keep for every one of these threads is huge, right? For every processor that is available in the multiprocessor, I need to keep this affinity index for this thread. That may be too much metadata that the scheduler has to maintain on behalf of every thread. And therefore, there's a variant of minimum intervening, which is called limited minimum intervening, which is saying, don't keep this affinity index for all the processors, just keep it for the top few processors. So the affinity index, if it is 2 or 3, those are the ones that I care about. If the affinity index is 20 or 30, I'm not going to pick that. So why bother keeping all of the affinity index for a particular thread? Just keep the top candidates. That's the idea behind limited minimum intervening scheduling policy. The last policy I'm going to introduce you to, it's called minimum intervening plus queuing. The idea is still the same, that I want to look at whether intervening threads that ran on a particular processor with respect to this thread that I'm trying to schedule at this point of time. But when I make a scheduling decision that TI is going to run on a particular processor, it may be that this particular processor, PJ, may already have some other threads that are going to run on it. And that's the idea behind minimum intervening plus queue. Again, I want to explain this a little bit more detail. So in minimum intervening scheduling plus queuing, what we are saying is it's not only the affinity index of TI with respect to a particular processor that I'm going to look at, but I'm also going to look at the queue for this particular processor. Why do we need to do that? Well, if TI is going to be scheduled on this particular processor, PJ, maybe there is a scheduling queue associated with PJ, which already has some number of threads to be run. And therefore, even though I'm picking the processor PJ based on cache affinity, by the time TI gets to actually run, two other threads are going to run before it. So this was when TI ran last, and I might find that the affinity for TI with respect to PJ is 2, just like in this previous example that I gave you. The affinity is 2, so it looks like a good choice to put TI on PJ if this turns out to be the minimum. But when I make that decision, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick this thread TI in the scheduling queue of PJ, and if the scheduling queue of PJ has TM and TN already populated, then what's going to happen, time is now, but by the time TI gets to run on the processor PJ, TM and TN would also have run on the processor, right? So even though the affinity index that I computed at the point of the scheduling decision, this is a scheduling decision. At the scheduling decision, I made a decision to put TI on PJ based on its affinity with respect to processor PJ. But unfortunately, the reality is that TI is not going to run immediately, but it is going to run much later in time. And by the time it gets to run, two other threads that are already sitting in the queue of PJ, they're going to run. And therefore, the cache will be more polluted than what we thought it was going to be at this point of time. So that's the reason that this scheduling policy is called minimum intervening plus queue, saying that not only should you take into account the affinity index of a thread with respect to a particular processor, but you should also look at the queue of the processor and ask the question, is the queue already populated? In that case, the processor that I want to pick TI to run on is the min of I plus Q, where I is the affinity index and Q is the size of the scheduling queue associated with this particular processor, PJ. So that's the last scheduling policy. So we basically have introduced 5 different scheduling policies: first come, first served, fixed processor, last processor, minimum intervening, and minimum intervening plus queuing. And as I mentioned, these 2 scheduling policies will really not be having the information for a thread with respect to all the processes in the system, because in a large-scale processor, it may be infeasible to do that. So what you do is you limit the amount of information that you keep for every one of these threads. Remember, one of the attributes of a good operating system is to make a decision very quickly and get out of the way. And from that point of view, the less information it has to sift through in order to make a scheduling decision, the faster it can do its work.